1st, 2012. I'm Bob Bartlett, and I'm sitting with legendary NASCAR driver Marvin Penn.
Thank you, kind sir. Thank you, Robert.
Marvin, you drove Maserati Tipo 151 at Daytona. It was what? It was chassis number 4, and it had a, was that a 429 in there?
Well, it was a Ford race engine. Owned by Briggs Cunningham at the time. And they brought it to Daytona to set a closed course record. That's what the deal was. And I took it out, tried it out. It didn't handle real good. I guess the engine was, you know, a different weight. And I came back in with it, and Leonard Wood, who was my driver, the Wood Brothers at the time, I said, Leonard, the car is not handling it. So he set the protective control in and something else on it. And so then they fueled it. It had that old flip lid on the back. They fueled it, and I said, now I'm going to take it out. I said, if it fuels it anywhere near decent, I said, I'll give you the signal so it has a timer ready the next time I come around. And it felt decent. You know, it wasn't perfect, but I figured I could get a hot lap in with it. So I give them the signal, and I go flat out down the back stretch. And that sucker thought it was an airplane. The air got under, lifted it up, and came down on the right front corner and on the top, and I slid around the turn there in the grass over there by the tunnel, the old tunnel. And then the sucker caught fire on me. And you know, you can't get out of them because the door is open on the top. And I couldn't get out, and I was flattened down pretty good too. And I kicked and crammed and wouldn't budge. So Bill Wimble and there were four guys, Steve Petrazic, Firestone, and Tiny Long, my memory's going bad here. Bill Wimble and Ernie Cahan. I got it.
Okay.
I'm all right. I came back.
Okay.
And Ernie Cahan, they were coming through the tunnel, and they seen I was in trouble there. So they pulled up to the fence. High fence, got on the hood of the car and jumped over the fence, and Steve Petrazic and Tiny Lund came with a car out of the garage area, out of the pit, and they came over there, and they lifted the car up enough for me to kick the door partly open, and I got about halfway out and blew up on them. So they dropped it on me across my back, and I heard Steve Petrazic out there. I was kicking my legs out, my legs were out. And I was kicking my leg. He said, come on, he's still kicking. Let's get him. They came in the car and lifted that car. Steve and Traffic went temporarily blind. That was Steve and Traffic. He was in there for fire control. And they came in and lifted him. And I started out a little more and kind of not one, then grabbed me by the leg and pulled me off the car. So that was one of my worst days, one of my best days. Worst days you get in trouble, and the best day I got out of it.
Right. Now you were not able to drive in the Daytona 500 that year, is that right?
That's true. I was in the hospital, and so being Tiny Lund was one of the guys that helped me out. The Wood Brothers came by the hospital and asked me what I thought about the Tiny in because he didn't have a ride. I didn't care. I was like, you know, that's good. That's for him. He helped me. So then he ended up winning the race with my car.
So Tiny Lund in Marvin Ponch's car wins the Daytona 500 after that heroic rescue.
That's right.
It kept this guy here so we could talk to him today.
I'm very fortunate to be here. Yep. If it wasn't for those guys, I wouldn't be here.
Yep.
And when I was trapped in there, now people tell you this, believe me, everything I did bad in my life flashed in front of me like a TV screen. And then I figured, well, now what's my wife and children going to do? You know, that won't go through your mind. And believe me, if I can tell you that.
Wow. Well, thank you so much.
How you doing, sir?
Thank you. You bet.
Yep. Okay.